Hey guys, today I'll be telling you how to make fortune teller, like this one. Sorry about the noises. Yeah, I made like six of them already, but let's begin.
Okay, so you need paper, scissors, some colors, something to write with. Okay, so first you want to... So you want to fold it like this. Like, okay, just watch. So you want to fold it like this, and then you want to cut this excess off. And yes, this is just an excuse to make another one. I made one. Okay, so it should look like this. You want to open up, and where it's inside out, where you can close it, you want to take this top part and then fold it to where the line is. Not in the line, but to where the line is. And then for the other ones, you want to make more triangles, which will actually be squares, which is kind of weird. But, yeah. I'm not really good at making these though, so... Okay, so after that, it should look like this. Then you want to turn it to the back, and you see this where this line is. You want to make it up like this. Where the crease is, you want to fold it right here. To where the line is, not exactly where the line is, but to the line. So that way it's like this. Like, it's not touching the line, but it's near the line. You get it, I guess? I don't know. I don't know if you do, but... And you want to repeat that for the other ones as well. Try not to overlap it. But yeah. Okay, so after that, it should look like this. And then you want to turn to the back. And then you want to fold it to the middle where it separates. This part is a little hard and tricky. This is one reason why you shouldn't make the other triangles on the other side to be touching the line. Then it'll be kind of crooked, like this one. This one is one of my favorites, though. Let's see, it's like kind of pink out, and you can see the middle. Okay. After you fold it, you want to, like, where the middle is, where the flaps kind of open. See? You want to turn it upside down, and then you stick your fingers in there. This part may be weird, but it's the way my cousin taught me. You want to make it sure it's like that. And then you want to put in your chain, where the little slit is, you want to put in your chain so that way it folds up, and so that way it's not flat. And then you should be able to curve it into the thing. Yeah, I'm going to write some stuff in here. So when I write, I normally like fold back and forth because I want to make sure I can read it. You can put like random stuff. Cat, turtle. And then the inside you can write numbers or alphabet, I guess. I don't know. So I'm just gonna write A, B, C. Oh my gosh. So, Z got left out. Okay. And then, yeah, I'm gonna write the rest later. But yeah, these are super fun to make. some of them are. Okay, so, yeah.